today we are going to see a chapter in English. Its name is Monday Morning Blues. Let us read. Read along with me. Monday mornings always found Tom's fire miserable because with it began another week slow suffering in school. Tom lay in the bed and thought, if I were sick, I could stay away from school and go fishing. He thought further about it. What could we do? But despite all his attempts to detect some symptoms, he could not find anything wrong with himself. His hope began to fail. Suddenly, he discovered something. One of his upper front tooth was loose. He decided to use it as an excuse for not going to school. He was about to start mourning. He remembered that if his aunt came to know, she would pull it out, and that would hurt. So he decided to use the tooth as an excuse on some other day. He went back to thinking of some other way to fake illness. He remembered hearing the doctor describe an illness that had caused the patient to lose a finger. The boy eagerly drew his sore toe from under the sheet and held up for inspection. It seemed worthwhile to chance it, so he fell groaning on the bed. But Sid, who lay in the next of the bed, slept on. Tom groaned louder, but no result from Sid. Finally, he got up, shook Sid hard, and then went back to the bed groaning. Sid yawned and stretched, then brought himself up on the elbow with a snort and began to stare at Tom. Tom went on groaning. This blue t-shirt is Sid and this pink t-shirt is Tom. He's holding his toe and groaning. What's going on? Asked Sid. Frightened by the noise Tom was capable of producing. No response. Hey, Tom! Tom! What is the matter, Tom? Tom moaned out. Oh, Sid. Don't joggle me. But I must. Don't groan like that, Tom. It is awful. How long have you been groaning this way? Oh, Sid, I'm dying. No, you ain't dying. It makes my fresh call to hear you. What is the matter? I must forgive you everything, said Tom. In a fresh round of grunts. When I'm gone, you give my window glass and my cat with one eye tooth back to the town and tell her. But Sid had flown downstairs and informed Aunt Polly. Come quick, Auntie. Tom is dying. What rubbish! I don't believe it. But the poor lady hurried upstairs with Sid, Mary at her heels. Her face grew white and her lips trembled. What is the matter with you, Tom? She cried. Oh, Auntie, my toe! What is the matter with your toe? Oh, Auntie, my sore toe is going to fall off. The old lady sank down in a chair with relief. She laughed a little, then cried a little, then did both together. This made her feel better. She said, "Tom, you really did frighten me. Now you stop this nonsense and get out of the bed." Tom felt foolish. Tom felt foolish of his act now that he was caught. He said, "Auntie, my toe hurt so much that I wasn't worried about my tooth at all. What is the matter with your tooth?" "Well, one of them is loose and it aches awfully." "Open your mouth and let me see," said his auntie. "Yes, it is loose." "All right, but you're not going to die because of that. Mary, get me a silk thread and a chunk of fire out of the kitchen." Tom said, "Oh, Auntie, please." "Auntie, don't pull it out. It doesn't hurt me anymore." "Please don't, Auntie. I don't want to stay home from school." Here you can see the dark pink lady is the auntie, and this yellow color woman is Mary, and she's holding a chunk of fire. It's nothing but a charcoal, and the auntie is holding a silk thread. And here at the back you can see the bedpost. "Oh, you do, don't you? So all this drama was because you thought you didn't get to stay at home from school and go fishing. Tom, I love you so much, but I am very unhappy with you. You seem to try every way you can break this old heart with your shocking behavior." By this time, the dental instruments were ready. The old lady fastened one of the silk thread to Tom's tooth with a loop and tied the other to the bedpost. Then she seized the chunk of fire, and suddenly the thrust, it was almost into the boy's face. The tooth hung dangling by the bedpost now. This story was written by Mark Twain. Thank you, friends. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel for more videos. Bye, friends.